Hi, I'm John Aynsley from Doulos. I'm going to talk about SystemVerilog as the new Verilog. So SystemVerilog has been called the world's first HDVL, that is, Hardware Design and Verification Language. SystemVerilog has features for RTL design, for assertions, and for hardware verification. If you're looking for a very general introduction to SystemVerilog and how it fits in with other language standards, I recommend my video SystemC versus SystemVerilog that you can find on the Doulos website or on YouTube. In this particular video, I'm going to talk more about SystemVerilog as the replacement for Verilog. So SystemVerilog has evolved over the years and it's borrowed language features from Verilog itself, from Superlog, from VHDL, PSL, the property specification language, from the C programming language, and from the Vera test bench automation language. This year, SystemVerilog and Verilog are being unified into a single standard, SystemVerilog 2009. So from 2009 onwards, SystemVerilog will become the new Verilog. In this video, I'm not going to concentrate on the more esoteric SystemVerilog language features, but I'm going to talk about the features that Verilog programmers might find useful, in particular, look at the features that Verilog borrows from C. So Verilog has always had a four-valued data type, which is known as logic in SystemVerilog, where each individual bit is represented by four values, 0, 1, X and Z. SystemVerilog adds a range of so-called two-valued data types, where each individual bit can just take two values, 0 or 1. Those data types are bit, byte, short int, int and long int, that represent 1, 8, 16, 32 and 64-bit integers, respectively. Pretty much the same as the C data types. SystemVerilog also borrows a whole range of user-defined data types from C, including enum, struct, union and typedef. It then adds unpacked and packed array and struct types that I'll talk about in just a little bit more detail. So let's start with an example of an enum. In SystemVerilog, you can define an enum variable, as shown by the top example. So here, my variable is an enumeration that can take one of the three possible values, red, green, and blue. We can also define a proper data type as an enum, and then reuse that data type to define variables. So at the bottom, we have a typedef enum, defining a new data type, my type, that can take one of the three values, red, green, blue. And we then use myType to define a variable, myVariable. Here's an example creating a typedef for a struct. And you'll immediately see that this example has some striking similarities with C, as well as a few differences that are unique to SystemVerilog. So the fields within the struct start off with a 4-bit logic data type. Logic 3:0x defines x as a 4-bit vector, and logic is a four-valued type, so each bit of x can take one of the four values, 0, 1, x, or z, so it actually requires 8 bits to represent x. Y is a 32-bit signed integer, and flag is a single two-valued bit. If we declare this as an unpacked struct, then the compiler is free to decide how much memory it's going to allocate. It's probably going to allocate four 32-bit words, so three 32-bit words, one for each of the fields within the struct. On the other hand, if we declare this as a packed struct, then the compiler is obliged to store each bit of the representation in contiguous bits in the implementation. So we're actually going to get 8 bits, 32 bits, and 1 bit for each of these three fields, making 41 bits in total. Well, that's just the beginning. So SystemVerilog indeed adds a number of data types that will be familiar to C programmers. It also goes a lot further. SystemVerilog adds packages that will be familiar to users of VHDL and Java, also very similar to C++ namespaces. SystemVerilog adds multidimensional arrays that you'll be familiar with from VHDL. It adds strings, this time not as strings in Verilog and not as null-terminated strings in C, but rather as proper objects like the C++ string class. SystemVerilog adds dynamic arrays, that is arrays that are resizable at runtime, flexible stretchy arrays if you like. It adds associative arrays, like the C++ STL map or a Perl hash. And furthermore, SystemVerilog adds classes, meaning a full object-oriented programming language with single inheritance. So that's a very significant addition to Verilog and to C. And then finally, SystemVerilog adds constraints to support full constrained random generation, although a discussion of that is outside the scope of this particular video. Now let's have a look at control statements. Verilog has always had if and case statements. In SystemVerilog, those two statements are generalised to support full wildcard comparisons with both if and case forms of control statements. SystemVerilog has a whole family of loops, including for, for each, while, do while, repeat and forever loops, and adds break and continue statements, much as you'd find in C. SystemVerilog has support for proper functions and procedures, which is achieved using the task automatic construct, unlike the rather limited form of tasks and functions that Verilog supported. SystemVerilog has full process control, so you can dynamically fork processes, suspend, kill and disable processes, and wait for processes to finish. SystemVerilog also adds the DPI, or direct program interface, and that supports direct calls between SystemVerilog and C, which is very convenient. So have a look at this fragment of code. Is this C or is it SystemVerilog? Well, of course, it could be either. This for statement would be equally at home in the C programming language or in SystemVerilog. It's a slight cheat because if we complete this code by expanding the dot dot dot, then we've got to commit ourselves one way or another. So C uses braces for this particular controls construct. SystemVerilog uses the begin-end block statement. Verilog has always supported the always block, which in more recent times has become very widely used in the context of synthesis. SystemVerilog adds a refinement to the always block with three forms of explicitly synthesizable process. Always FF for synthesizing logic that's clocked, always latch for transparent latches, and always COM for synthesizing combinational logic. And there's lots more besides. So Verilog has always supported parameterized modules. SystemVerilog goes a lot further by supporting type parameterization. So the data type of a variable can be passed in as a parameter to a module when that module is instantiated. SystemVerilog supports interfaces. And if you've not come across SystemVerilog interfaces before, think of them as being like in-out struct ports in Verilog, if you can imagine such a thing. So you can have a single port that's bidirectional, and within that port are multiple elements, multiple fields, some of which could act as inputs, some of which could act as outputs. And SystemVerilog supports wildcard port connections. So we can abbreviate port connection lists by using a wildcard, something like dot star, which would connect up ports to variables or nets with the same name. So I've briefly highlighted some of the features in SystemVerilog that make it a better Verilog, also showing a number of constructs that are borrowed from the C programming language. In SystemVerilog terms, that's just the tip of the iceberg, and there are lots more constructs, particularly those to do with object-oriented programming, constrained random verification, and classes, but all of those are outside the scope of this particular video. However, if you do want to know more, at Doulos, we're a training company and we can provide you with training courses in Verilog, SystemVerilog, VHDL, SystemC and a range of other standards. You can find a lot of resources on the Doulos website, www.doulos.com, including more information on Verilog and SystemVerilog.